Hello there guys, welcome back to my channel Abdul, Wajid Vlogs. Today we are going to review Himalayan Scram 411. I am going to tell you the differences between the original Himalayan and the Scram 411 and what comforts do we get in the city ride.
I was about to shoot this video very long back actually. Actually I have revealed the bike Scram 411 when it got launched. I was very honored by the opportunity given by them.
I guess we're grown-ups now. Couldn't ever imagine even having doubts, but not everything works out. Now I'm out dancing with strangers. You could be casually dating. That much all changes so fast. I see la vida, I see. Yeah, that's just life, baby.
Pravallika motors, currency nagar.
They took the bike to the petrol bunk to get it refilled, and once they are back we'll go have the test ride.
जाएगा तुम्हें सो फाइनली रैम 411 pickup is good.
You can easily reach 100 kmph of speed.
I think the top speed is about 135, around 135 and 140 kmph. There will be no major differences in top speed in Himalayan, original Himalayan and this Scram 411. Now let me tell you the major difference in original Himalayan and this Scram 411. It's the front wheel actually. The front wheel is about 19 inches in this bike, and the original Himalayan gets 21 inches of steel rim. I feel that the engine is more refined to the previous compared with the previous version of the Himalayan, 2021 version of the Himalayan. The brakes are effective too. It has good bite. I think there is no difference in the old version and the newer version of the brakes. Both have good bite in the front and also in the rear. You'll get a dual channel ABS in this bike. We are now on Bandar Road. Just to test the performance of this bike in bumper to bumper traffic or the regular city traffic. I'm 5 feet 6 inches tall, and as you can see this is the reach I'm getting on my foot. Though I can't touch my heel completely down, but it's comfortable enough. the 70 kmph is the sweet spot for this bike. I'll tell you why. I can't feel any vibrations when I'm riding in 70 kmph. The engine is very smooth in this speed. I'm feeling much comfortable than the original Himalayan when I'm riding in the city. See, this is what I am saying. Look at the handle, the way it's moving.
You can't ride your Himalayan with this much of ease in the city just because of the front wheel size.
The weather today is very hot actually in Vijayawada. It's undercoating and short footings scenes going on right now.
Let's quickly get back to the showroom and I'll tell you more about the specifications and details of this bike. And I'll also try to differentiate it with the Himalayan, the OG Himalayan. Let's start from the front. You will get 190/19 Seat Grip XL tire in the front. In the rear section, you will get 120/90/17, which is similar to the OG Himalayan. You will get 300mm disc plate with 2 piston floating caliper in the front. In the rear, you will get 240mm disc plate with a single piston floating caliper similar to Himalayan, but you won't get switchable ABS in the Scram 411. This motorcycle comes with telescopic 41mm forks in the front with 200mm of travel. In the rear, you will get monoshock with 180mm of wheel travel. You will get the same 7-inch headlight with halogen bulb and LED daytime running light with newly designed headlight visor, and to my surprise, it's not made of fiber. You will get newly designed instrument cluster with a toggle switch. You can switch from trip A, trip B, trip F and odometer of the bike. At the bottom you can find fuel indicator, battery indicator, ABS indicator, neutral check light indicator and engine check light indicator. You can now monitor your speed in kmh and mph, that is kilometer per hour and miles per hour. The handlebar is untouched. You'll get the same handlebar from Himalayan. You'll get halogen turn indicators and LED danger light, similar to the OG Himalayan. Scram 411 now comes with newly designed front and rear mudguards, which I personally like. They look compact. The fuel capacity of the motorcycle remains the same, which is 15 liters, but you'll also get a new fairing, and the side door is also changed a bit. It now comes with a small air outlet like design. Scram 411 comes with a single seat, which has a similar cushioning like Himalayan. It's soft. You can go touring on this motorcycle with this seat, no problem. But the pillion seat is a bit tiny and it won't be comfortable for long rides. At least you got a strong grab rail for city rides. Seat height of this motorcycle is 795mm, which is 5mm lesser than Himalayan. You'll get a ground clearance of 200mm, which is 20mm lesser than Himalayan. You won't get main stand with this motorcycle, which is the major drawback according to me. There are no changes made in the engine. It's still single cylinder, 4-stroke air-cooled engine, which produces 32 Nm of torque at 4500 RPM and 24.3 bhp at 6500 RPM. So that's all about the Scram 411. Hope I covered all the points.
You can take a screenshot of this image to know more about the on-road prices of Scram 411 in Vijayawada. I thank Royal Enfield Pravallika Motors, Currency Nagar, Vijayawada for giving me this opportunity. Thank you.
So that's it for today, guys. Please like, share and subscribe, and don't forget to hit the bell icon for more videos. Thank you.